When I assign a texture to a material in Blender, the corresponding UV layout of the respective object is used, because by default in a texture is the projection is set to flat. This means that the UV layout of is used for the respective object. When I click on the texture and press the Ctrl and T key, provided that the node wrangler is activated, that add-on, which is already available in Blender, then these two nodes are created automatically, with which I can then manipulate the texture. So if you have a texture that matches the model with correctly designed UVs, you do not need these two nodes. And all you have to do is to set the whole thing to flat and leave it there. So now there is, of course, the variant that you can use a 3D object where you have no UV layout and still want to apply a texture. And for this, there is the option of to set the whole thing to generated or to object. If I set the whole thing to generated, then now my texture is no longer based on from the UV layout to the model, but from the bounding box. That's why I have the whole bounding boxes of the objects here. This means that the texture is set to is dragged onto the bounding box. So if I look at the box here, then the texture from bottom left to top right, this works. No distortion of the texture. No problem here on the tarp either. Here we can already see that the texture is distorted and displayed unevenly. In this direction, we can see a clear distortion caused by the bounding box. The Suzanne model also shows a slight distortion in the texture can be observed. This means that if I now, for example, click on this ball and press S for scale and Y, and this axis scale the whole thing, we see that we have a scaling of the texture. This is what happens with generated. In the generated mode, the projection type flat doesn't use the UV layout anymore, but instead applies a simple planar projection from above. And if I now change flat to box, it will also be displayed by projected onto it from all sides, from each direction via the bounding box. And then, as explained earlier, we can see that even with this model, the texture is very strongly distorted. So I'll put that back. It behaves differently when I use object. With object, the bounding box is not used, but the pivot point of a single object. The texture is currently repeated and tiled. I'm now changing the setting from repeat to clip. This enables a better display. With clip, the texture is positioned at the object's pivot point. So, for example, if I now click on the cube, turn the camera briefly to get a better view from above. So here is the pivot point, and here is where the texture begins with this object. The pivot point for the sphere is at this point. For this object here, it is slightly twisted, which looks strange, but it is still correct. Of course, we can also move the pivot point or origin. I'll select the plane, go to options, and turn on origins. I select my 3D model, and then I position the texture based on the origin. Now, of course, we can imagine it. If I now move twist or move the origin, I naturally also change the data of the model itself, which is, of course, something impractical. Now we also have the possibility to use this origin as well differently via another object. So if I now go to the texture coordinate node, then I now have here below the option to select a different object. I press Shift and A and add a sphere null object. I press the eyedropper and select the object. Now we see the disappeared textures of all other objects, because all textures are now looking at this one object. So if I now press the G key, we can see that I can now use this texture long travel on all other objects and move them, because I now have the position over this object. All objects have the same material. So let's take that out of here again. Next, let's take a look at this node, mapping. There is now different types here, once here point and once texture. Point means that I have access to the working area of the texture, or called the UV map. The texture is located on the workspace. If I change the enlarge the workspace, I have to adjust the entire geometry of the workspace accordingly, and then gain which results in our texture appear smaller. This means that if I now set everything to point and increase the scaling to 5, for example, our texture will automatically become smaller. This happens because when I set the workspace to 5, it becomes 5 times larger. It must be reduced accordingly to fit the geometry again, and therefore the texture automatically becomes smaller. So I'll put that back again. The other way around, if I now put up here, change the type from point to texture. This does not change the workspace from the UV map or from the texture, but the texture itself. If I now set scaling to 5 here, then I do the texture 5 times larger, so our texture will be larger. I'll change this to 2. Our texture becomes twice as large. That is the only difference between texture and point. I hope that was understandable. I changed the projection type from flat to box. Flat is now like this again, that the texture is projected onto it from above, and with box, the texture is projected from all 6 sides of the cube are projected onto it. If we switch to object, the texture is projected onto the pivot point position of the object. So if I now change the whole thing here from clip to repeat, then our texture is displayed repeatedly. Of course, I could also switch from repeat to mirror. Then the respective following texture is mirrored once. I'll set it back to repeat again. In most cases, it makes sense to set the texture coordinate node to object, especially if no UV layout is available. This way, you can easily set the seams of the textures by setting the parameter blend to merge them together. When I get closer to the sphere, you can see the seams better. Especially with the box projection type, these seams are visible. You can then simply use the blend parameter to gently blend them together. This will give you a seamless result. This corresponds to the triplanar node of all the other renderers. The mapping node is not absolutely necessary. I could also delete it. I move object directly to vector. If you have not set the mapping, it doesn't matter anyway. Only if you want to position the texture differently, make it smaller, or then the mapping node would make sense. If you want more movies like this, press the thumbs up and subscribe this channel, and see you next time.